I really wanted to demonstrate the full power of combining PyTorch Lightning with weights and biases. This is sort of a Reese's situation. It's two great tastes that taste great together. So I'm going to show you how to do a PyTorch Lightning callback that gives you the ability to do fully flexible media logging with weights and biases. If you just use PyTorch Lightning, then you would be able to log metrics pretty easily. But if you wanted to log things like the input and output of your model, you're going to have a little bit more trouble with just base PyTorch Lightning. This is a problem because DNNs often fail in these very pernicious kind of silent ways. You know, the loss is going down, but it's actually getting every single example from one class wrong. Maybe you have a bug in your code and the way you're calculating your accuracy is incorrect. These can be very difficult bugs to track down unless you actually look at how things go into your model and what comes out directly. Neural networks are designed to take human interpretable data like images, sounds, videos, and produce something that humans would be able to produce themselves out of it, like a label. And so sometimes the only way to debug them is to compare them to what a human thinks. Logging media is a really great way to find these silent, super scary bugs in your machine learning model. In order to be able to take advantage of that with PyTorch Lightning and weights and biases, we're going to need this callback here. There's maybe a couple of other ways to do it, but they all are going to require a little bit of extra code. So here I'm inheriting from PyTorch Lightning's callbacks. Basically, I define a whole bunch of methods for it. Like, this is what I want this callback to do when the validation epoch starts, what I want it to do when it ends, what I want it to do when a training epoch starts and a training epoch ends. This keeps all the code organized, make sure things run at the right time. It's a really nice interface. So we're going to inherit from that to make our image prediction logger. It's going to take some particular samples from the validation set and their labels. And then at the end of every validation epoch, it's going to compute the outputs of our model on those images, get those predictions, and then log them to weights and biases with wnb.image and a caption that says, okay, this is what the model predicted, and this is what the true label was. That way you can actually find, oh, hey, there's an error in my labeling. What should be a 4 is actually labeled a 5 or something like that. So we add this by defining this on validation epoch end method of the callback. And since we're in the callback interface, it has access to both the thing that's training the model and the model itself. Lastly, we can set up this trainer, customize some of the options. Passing in that logger is something that we want to do. The trainer is what we use to configure a lot of the computation, the ML engineering kind of side of things, asking for GPUs, asking for TPUs, saying that we're running it in a distributed setting. This is done in the trainer section. This is also where we're going to use that custom callback that we wrote. You provide a list of callbacks, and so we're going to provide our image prediction logger callback here. Here's where all of our hard work finally pays off. All of that logging stuff that we did is what is resulting in this dashboard that we have here. Here's those media examples, those particular inputs that we logged with that custom callback here. We can make that a little bigger if we want to look at more of them. We can see by the time that these images got logged, we're doing pretty well. It looks like we've made a mistake on this one here, predicted a 3, but the label is actually a 5. So we're not perfect yet. But it doesn't look like there's any gross errors happening. I didn't shuffle the labels on accident. I'm not miscalculating my accuracy or anything like that.